हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिस्टर राजेश आर चौगले, लेक्चरर इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक थुड़े। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी ए चैप्टर फ्रॉम सब्जेक्ट मैकेनिकल वर्किंग ड्राइंग, हैविंग कोर्स कोड 22341। द नेम ऑफ चैप्टर इज डेवलपमेंट ऑफ सर्फेसेस। We know as a mechanical diploma engineer, he should possess thorough understanding of drawing, which includes clear spatial visualization of objects, reading and interpreting a wide variety of production drawings. So this course aims at developing ability to visualize and draw development of surfaces, curves of intersection of various solids, and knowledge of limit fit tolerances, etc., which is required in the industry. So the unit outcomes are: first one, after the presentation you will be able to draw development of lateral surfaces of prism, cylinder, then identify parts where DLS is required, that is application. What are the prerequisites of this topic? The prerequisites are projections of solids and sections of solids. Projections means we have to put the solid according to given condition on HP or VP, inclined to HP or inclined to VP. And sections of solid means we have to cut the solid by a inclined plane to the HP or it may be to the VP. Yes, introduction. Let's imagine a solid is enclosed in a wrap paper. So what is DLS, developmental lateral surface, first? So you have to imagine that a solid is enclosed or wrapped in a thin sheet or paper. If wrapper is opened out and laid out on the flat plane, then the wrapped paper is development of solid. It can be cleared from figure below. See, this is the cylinder having diameter D and height H. Now it is wrapped by this paper, okay, towards to its entire curved surface. This is top and this is the bottom, okay. Now this wrapped surface is laid down on flat plate or flat surface, then we will get a rectangular foil or rectangular sheet having height H and length equals to perimeter of circle, and these are the two, top circle and bottom circle. So this figure is called as development of surfaces. Now after the development, what you will do, you are going to fold this development, then you will get a hollow. You will get a hollow cylinder. Next, in previous problem we have seen development of cylinder. Now here you can see development of pentagonal prism. Now in this pentagonal prism, it is wrapped by a sheet like this from top and bottom and to its lateral surfaces, and now we are going to open the sheet and lay it down on the surface, then we will get the, that is DLS, development of lateral surfaces of prism, okay. And after folding it, we will get a hollow prism, hollow pentagonal prism. Now, what is the principle of surface of development? The principle is every line must be true length and every area must be true area or showing the actual shape. Or we can define it as development of lateral surfaces is a graphical method of obtaining the area of surfaces of solid. It is a graphical method of obtaining area of surfaces of solid. Okay, so what after DLS? So after DLS, what we are going to do? First of all, whatever hollow object we are going to make of sheet metal, first we will draw its development on a paper. Then according to the drawing, we are going to mark all the measurements as per the drawing sheet on foil, metal foil. Then we are going to cut that metal foil, and last we will bend it to form a hollow solid. So application of DLS, it is essential in many industries such as sheet metal industry, then automobiles, then aircrafts, and then shipbuilding. Okay, to make article out of sheet metal, how we can make? As I have explained earlier, prepare the development, cut the metal sheet according to shape and size, and fold it to get required shape, the hollow shape. You can see applications here. Funnels. These are the funnels which are used in shops. So these are made up by development first, and then bent to form the funnel. Cylinder or tubes can be made by development. Hoppers, we can see the hoppers in flour mill. So in the flour mill we see the hoppers which are made up by development of surfaces. Storage tank, these such used storage tanks are made up from metal sheets which are bent to certain angle, and these sheets are cut according to the development, according to storage tank we require. Next, what are methods of development? So methods of development are parallel line development, first method, radial line development, second, and approximation method, third. Parallel line method is useful for prism and cylinder where the edges or curved surface is parallel to the axis of that solid. Then next, radial line method is used for pyramid and cone where the edges or curved surface is not parallel to the axis of that solid, or where the circumferential points or end points are at equal distance from the apex. In case of pyramid and cone, we are going to use this radial line method. And approximation method, approximation methods is used for spheres. Spheres are two curved bodies, hence we cannot use this parallel line method or radial line method. Hence we will use an approximate method. Development of lateral surfaces. So see here, cylinder, this is the cylinder. Cylinder we are going to unfold it by sheet and open the sheet. We will get this perimeter, length equals to perimeter pi d, and then height equals to d. In prism we are going to get a rectangular foil where height will be h, and this S will be the edge of base of prism, and now it, as it is a pentagon, we will get 5 edge of bases. So the perimeter equals to 5 times S. Now radial line method, see, you can use radial line method in case of cone, okay, where all the outermost points are equidistant from the apex A. Now the theta wrap will be given by R by L into 360 degree, where R is the radius of base of cone and L is the slant height, or we can say longest generator. These are the pyramids. You can see here development of tetrahedron, where tetrahedron is made up of 4 triangles. So you can see this is the base triangle, and these are the 4 outermost triangles. Cube is made up from 6 squares. Parallel method for cylinder and prism, radial line method for pyramid and cone. Now first parallel method, we will see a problem on it and you will get how to draw the DLS of prism and cylinder. So problems on prism first. Draw the development of lateral surface of square prism with edge of base 30 mm and axis length 50 mm, resting on its base on HP with two of its base edges perpendicular to VP. So first of all, we will write given. So what is given solid? It's a square prism. Edge of base. Now given edge of base is 30 mm, edge of base 30 mm, axis height 60 mm, it is given. Then how it is kept? It is kept on HP on two edges perpendicular to VP. Now your knowledge of projections of solid must be good here. If you cannot draw according to the given, then there are chances that marks will be given to you or less. So see here, this is the top view and front view of object drawn according to given conditions. So it is a square prism, edge of base 30 mm, axis height 50, kept on HP on two edges perpendicular to VP. Now this square prism is kept on HP, so its base square will be viewed from top view. So we will draw first base. Now that base we can see in top view, so we will draw square in the top view first. So we can draw square like this. So we can draw square in top view. This is axis line xx. We can draw square like this and like this, type 1, type 2. When to draw type 1? When the edges are perpendicular to VP or edges are parallel to VP, when asked, then condition 1 will be drawn. And type 2 will be drawn when all the edge of base are equally inclined to VP. This is not given here, so we will draw this. So we have drawn here projection of square prism having edge of base 30 mm and axis height 50 mm. Next, now to draw DLS, development of surfaces, what we should do? So we have to extend this axis. Okay, extend the line of top base. Okay, we have to extend these two lines. Then next, take distance equals to AB in your compass. Take the distance equals to AB in your compass. Now put it on A point here and mark B, C, D, A. Similarly at the top, B, C, D, A. Okay, now AA BB, CC, DD and AA. These are the edges, so we have to draw them dark. So draw them dark, you will get edges. And see here, from A to A you will get AB, BC, CD and DA. These are the four sides of edge of base of prism. So this will equals to the perimeter of prism, which equals to four times side. Okay, so this is all the DLS of square prism. Okay, next, see here carefully. Second, the example, draw the DLS of pentagonal prism with edge of base 40 mm and height 80 mm, kept on HP on its base with edge of base parallel to VP and cut by an inclined plane 30 degree to HP and bisecting the axis of prism. So what is given here? A pentagonal prism, edge of base 40, height 80, kept on HP, edge of base VP, cut by angle 30 degree axis. Okay, given is written. Now see here, as it is kept on HP, so we will see its base, that is pentagon, in top view. So we will draw top view first. Then how to draw top view? It is given that edges of base are parallel to VP, or one of its edge of base is parallel to VP. So we will draw one of its edge of base parallel to VP, and then with 108 degree angle we will complete the pentagon. Name it A, B, C, D, E. Then on the XY axis take all the projections, and then take all the projections and then draw this front view of pentagonal prism. After this front view, see what is given next. It is cut by a plane 30 degree to HP and bisecting the axis. Okay, so as it is bisecting the axis, so we will plot a point at the midpoint of the axis. So midpoint will be at 45 mm from the bottom. Now from this point we will draw a line making angle 30 degree with HP, that is in front view. So we will draw this section line in front view, which makes angle equals to 30 degrees. Now after this, you have to find the cutting points. So how will you get the cutting points? So remember, when you will get a cutting point, when one edge is cut by a axis, one edge is cut by a cutting plane, then you will get one point. One edge, suppose this is a edge and you will cut it once, so you will get here one point, that is named as PA. If two edges are there and it is cut by a single plane, AA, BB, then you will get two points here. Here is the one PA point, here is the two PB point. Okay, so accordingly you have to find the cutting points and then plot in the DLS. And another point is, if base is cut by cutting plane, then at the bottom or at the top in between, so you will get two points. Okay, so for edge which is cut by a inclined plane, then you will get a one point, and for base cut by inclined plane, then you will get two points. So see, in this problem no base is cut, so no points on base we will get. You will get points on edges only. Now see, EE edge is cut by a EE edge is cut by plane, so here you will get point PE. So here you will get point PE. DD edge is cut by plane, so here you will get PD. Similarly, PA, PC, PB. So 5 edges are there, all edges are cut by cutting plane, then you will get 5 points here. Okay, for respective line, you will get respective point. Now next, how to draw DLS next? Then, first of all, draw the axis lines, draw the stop miss line parallel. Okay, next, draw one line AA parallel to the axis of prism. Then next, in compass, take distance, this 40 mm, that is AB distance or AE distance, mark it here, A, B, C, D, E, A. Similarly from top, A, B, C, D, E, and A. Then join this by faint lines. Do not join this by dark lines. Now, simple procedure is, now see this, point PE. Point PE is on line or edge E dash E dash. So, this point PE will line on E line here. Okay, so from the P, take your projections in this direction up to the line E E. So you will get point P here. Similarly, PD point, next PD point. PD point is on DD line. The next, project it on DD line and get PD point. Go for PA. PA point will appear twice as A line is appearing twice. Then next PC, PD, PD. So all points we have got here. So join these points with dark line. This will be your dark line and straight lines. As prism is cut by a plane, so we have to join the points by straight lines only. Okay, so finally you will see the development as like this. Okay, the next example, what is given? You have given square prism, edge of base 40, axis height 80, kept on its base equally inclined to VP, kept on HP on its base equally inclined to VP, circular hole 40 mm drill through it and bisects axis. Now you have to place this prism first. Okay, as it is kept on HP, so in the top view you are going to draw its front base. So you will draw a base equally inclined to VP like this, and edge of base is 40. How to draw equally inclined to VP like this? So first you have to draw a square of length 40 by 40. This will length will 40 and this length will be 40. Now join diagonal lines, then next draw here center line. Okay, now OA, take this OA distance equals to half of diagonal, put it on here center and mark four points on sides. Okay, and then draw this, so you will get ABCD square. Now take its projections in the front view and complete the projection of square prism. Now see, you have to find a circular hole of diameter 40 mm here. So, and which bisects the axis. So, at the center of axis, take distance radius equals to 20 mm in your compass and draw a circle. Okay. Then next, after drawing the circle, you have to divide by faint lines this circle into 8 equal parts or 12 equal parts. Okay. For 12 equal parts, you will get accurate curve in DLS. And now, these 12 equal parts, these 12 points you have to plot in, you have to take the projections in now top view. So this P1 point will be here. Now as the circular hole is passing through the square prism, so you will get 12 points in front of you. Similarly, other 12 points at the back side of your square prism. So totally you are getting 12 plus 12, 24 points. Okay, so now these points you have to plot in top view. So here you can see P1 and P12. P1 is in front, P12 is at the back. So you can take its projection. You can see here, you are here. So P1 is point here and P12 is here. Similarly, take other points P2 and P11. P2 is in front, P11 is at the back side. P3 and P10, PB and PD will be on the edge only. PB and PD, then next P9 and P4, P7, P6, P5, P8, and PC is not getting cut, so here will not you get any point. And next, then next, as it is parallel line method, first of all draw line AA, then next draw faint line equals to this much. How you are going to plot this much? This is much equals to perimeter. Perimeter of square equals to 4 times into side. What is side? 40 mm. 4 into 40 equals to 160 mm. Or take distance, take distance AB equals to 40 mm in compass, and mark point BCDA. Similarly BCDA, okay, then join this outer by dark line. Now you have unwound this small sheet, hence you will get here two circles. As it is, when it is folded, then you will see it as a circle, but when you unwound it, you will see these are to the two ellipses. So how to find out these? So next, see what. So between A and B there are 1, 2, 3 lines which are the we can say generators. So plot 1, 2, 3 line accordingly. So from A we will get this 1, 2, 3 points respectively. Take compass, put it on A and plot 1, 2, 3. Similarly 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and mark faint lines on it. Then next, this P1 and P12 in front view, P1 and P12 will be on 1-1 line and 12-12 line. So project it. So on 1-1 line you will get P1, and on 12-12 line you will get P12. Similarly project other points, P2, P11, P3, P10, QB, QD, PB, PD, and then next QB, QD. Similarly, so you will get here a curve ellipse, here you will get a curve ellipse. So in the next video we will going to see the problems on cylinder. Practice the problems on prism. If you master there, then you can master in all types, as the procedure is same for all the types. Thank you.